Hi, this video will cover the FIFO cost flow assumption for determining the cost of our inventory under a perpetual system. What I like to tell my students is FIFO stands for first in, first out, but I like to refer to it as first in, first sold. And the last items are in ending inventory. So that means that the first items that I get in my door, I will go ahead and sell those first and use that for my cost of goods sold. The items that are remaining will be the last items, so those will be my ending inventory. So with FIFO, I tend to show a little prop of a little can of French fries. This was my first job out there on Shaw 99. I was a fry girl in high school. And one of the things in the 80s they used to do is they used to push the food forward. They make a bunch of food at the same time, and then they try to go ahead and sell that. So the first items that they got in, they were pushing it to the customers to be sold. And so what happened is the items that were fresher, newly cooked, those would be the last items that came in, and those would tend to remain in our inventory when we would do our shift change. So FIFO and fast food approach, that's how I remember the FIFO. First items coming in are going to be the first items to be sold. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is, because on January 31st I sold 25 items, I'm going to start with the first items, which will be my beginning inventory. So I'm going to use my January 1st date. And that January 1st date, the price for these items were $10. Now keep in mind that these items are exactly the same. The only difference is when you bought them. So the price is just fluctuating. So it's increasing over time, but they're exactly the same items. So if you go and take the 10, oh, I put it in the wrong column. Let me move this over. January 1 here. And then I bought 10 items. And the price was $10. Let me see. Now I need, 25 items I need to account for? So there's only 20 items in that first date from the beginning inventory. So I only can get 20 from that layer. And then I'll have to go to the next first date, which is January 10th. So I'm going to put January 10th in here. And on January 10th, the prices went up to, $11. So if I sold some additional items, the price will then be 11. But because I'm selling a total of 25, I'm only going to take out 5 from those 30 items purchased. And that will give me a grand total of 255, and this will represent my cost of goods sold. Now for my ending inventory, keep in mind that if you sell 25 and you had 65 of items available, that would mean that if you subtract what you had available from your cost of goods sold, that 40 units would represent units on hand as of January 31st. And so, if we have 40 on hand and we're using FIFO, the last are the ending inventory, we'll start with the January 30th date. And we're talking about 15 units. And we're talking about, let's see, $12 is the price, the last price paid on the 30th. Now that's only 15, and we couldn't do the full 25 because we only had 15 on the January 30th purchase. So the next last date will be January 10th. And because we are accounting for a total of, 40 units on hand, we're going to have to, 15 minus 40. We're talking about 25 more items, and that price will be $11, and you will get $455, and this will represent the cost of your ending inventory that will appear as a debit in your merchandise inventory account. So the $255 will represent the cost of goods sold. The $455 will represent the ending inventory. If you were to add up these two amounts together, the $255 plus the $455, you get the cost of goods available for sale. So this is how you do a FIFO cost flow assumption on a perpetual system. Now, intentionally, the date January 31st is after these three dates. And if it were, let's say, January 15th, then you could not consider that any purchases made after the 15th. So you'd have to do your first and your last as of the date of the sale. Any questions, ask in the discussions. And remember, today is a great day to learn accounting.